Hello children, good morning to you all. Hope you have understood the content of the lesson, White Mice. I hope you even enjoyed also the story. Understand? I don't think it is good to play a prank on elders. You people please don't do such things. Enjoy the thing, but be careful while behaving with the elders. Based on this lesson, I am going to give you comprehensive questions today. Okay, let us start with the small questions. Here, one statement will be given. Under that statement, 3 to 4 questions will be there, A, B, C, so on. Just one line answers we are going to have for them. First, we are writing those questions. First one goes like this. Statement is, Mr. Ghosh's Mr. Ghosh's house was just behind the station. Ghosh's house was just behind the station is the statement. Based on this sentence, you are going to get 3 questions. Just one line answers. First one, A1. It goes like this. Who was Mr. Ghosh? I hope you know who was Mr. Ghosh. Already, lesson was explained 2-3 times about Mr. Ghosh. Who was Mr. Ghosh? Answer is, Mr. Ghosh was the station master . Where do you find station master? At railway station only, nowhere else. So no need to have any detailed answer for that. Why did the speaker go to his house? First of all, let us know who is the speaker. Who is the narrator? He is the speaker. Who is the speaker? Answer is, the boy is the speaker. The boy is the speaker. Third, why did the speaker go to his house? Why did the speaker go to his house? His house means whose house? Mr. Ghosh's house. He went there and waited for his grandfather. Waited for his grandfather. So, who was Mr. Ghosh? Mr. Ghosh was the station master. Who is the speaker? The boy is the speaker. Why did the speaker go to his house? He went there and waited for his grandfather. Why did he go there? To wait for his grandfather. Last question in this is, fourth question. The
I am sorry, it is D. What did he do there? Answer is, he had a cup of tea with two rasgullas and saw the miniature railway station. Or you can just write, he saw there the miniature railway station. That's also is enough. But in detail, what did he do after going there? He had a cup of tea with two rasgullas and then he saw the miniature railway station, model of the railway station. This is the set of questions for the first statement. Now the second statement is, a present for you and your grandfather. These are the spoken words. So we must write them in inverted commas. Just exactly what the person spoke, same words we are presenting here. So we must use inverted commas like this. We call even speech marks. A present for you and your grandfather. Exclamatory mark. A question. Who said this to whom? Answer is, Mr. Ghosh said this to the boy. B. What was the present? You must guess what was the present. It was a pair of white mice. It was a pair of white mice. What was the present? The present was a pair of white mice. Okay. Just a minute, excuse me. Last question in this set is, why did the speaker decide upon what? Why did the speaker decide upon that particular gift? What did it should be there? 1 minute. It should be what did the speaker decide upon that particular gift. Answer is, he decided to teach a lesson to his uncle using that gift. In the bracket, I would give you white mice. The white mice. So, these are the questions on the basis of the statements. Okay? So, what was the question? First question. A present for you and your grandfather. Who said this to whom? Mr. Ghosh said this to the boy. What was the present? The present was a pair of white mice. What did the speaker decide upon that particular gift? He decided to teach a lesson to his uncle because he put him in trouble, right? By playing a prank on him using this gift. That's it, children. So, now next bit is answer in detail. Now, you have answered the question on the basis of statements. Now, answer in detail. These are not so big questions. First one in this is, why did Uncle Ken rush out of his room? Answer is, Uncle Ken Uncle Ken rushed out of the room because he felt that felt something soft and furry was running about inside his clothes, So, why did Uncle Ken rush out of his room? Uncle Ken rushed out of his room because he felt something soft and furry was running about inside his clothes. Last question in this second one. How did Uncle Ken, how did Grandfather, how did grandfather try to solve Uncle Ken's problem? Answer is, Grandfather asked Uncle Ken to remove his clothes or take out, remove his clothes, na? One more better word we can have is take off his clothes and find out the reason for the mess. Mess means uncomfortable situation. How did Grandfather try to solve Uncle Ken's problem? Grandfather asked Uncle Ken to take off his clothes and find out the reason for the mess. This is the answer. These two are big answers. Those two questions based on statements are one line answers. So this is all about question answers. Tomorrow we will go with two more questions and other exercises. So that's it for today, children. Thank you.